First of all, would you tell us what that means and what kind of patients you see?
So vascular and interventional radiology is actually a specialty in medicine. It's its own specialty. It uses image guidance. So we use x-rays, ultrasound, MR, CT, and we use those imaging tools to do less invasive procedures. They're non-surgical procedures. So we can go with small catheters through tiny holes in the body. We can navigate through all the arteries, the veins, into solid organs. And we can treat all kinds of vessels. We can open things up, we can close things. And it is its own specialty. It's got a board certification. And both Adam and I have been doing this for many years here in the Baptist Health System.
Dr. Geronemus, give us an idea of the kind of patients that you see that walk through your office.
That's a very interesting question, Ed. And so with the great thing about vascular and interventional radiology is we see all types of patients, you know, ranging in age from young children up through the elder years. And we also deal with a bit of everything, especially, as Jim has said, the vascular disease. And when we talk about vascular disease, it really encompasses every system in the body, from the heart to the cardiovascular system, to the respiratory system, to the reproductive system. So we really get to see the whole gamut of patients.
Let's start with another phrase, and what is venous disease?
Venous disease, so you have arteries and veins that compromise the circulatory system. And venous disease is really the highway that blood gets back to the heart before it's pumped out and taken out by the arteries. So venous disease is any issue where the veins are malfunctioning. And generally when veins are malfunctioning, it's because veins bring blood back to the heart against gravity. So there's a system of valves, just like there is in plumbing. And when the valves malfunction, the venous system malfunctions.